appealing to religious faith as a power for winning the war, Monsignor Fulton J. Sheen.
What issues are involved in this war? One of the clearest answers that has ever been given to that question appeared recently in a book published in Germany entitled God and the People. This book, of course, bore the official sanction of Hitler himself. In it, we find this notion. Wherever there are ideas, there are fronts. Wherever there are fronts, there are struggles. There are only two ideas in the world. The idea of the German soul and the idea of Christianity. We are fighting not against men. We are fighting against an idea. This war is a struggle between the cross and the sword. Such is the official idea of Nazism. In other words, Hitler puts us on the side of the cross, on the side of charity and justice, faith and love of humanity. That being so, we should realize the necessity of prayer in our national life. And when we pray not that God may be on our side. We pray rather that we may be on His. Think of the great spiritual transformation that there would be in America if every Jew, Protestant, and Catholic, according to the light of his conscience, prayed one continuous hour a day for the president, for Congress, and for victory. Returning now to the point of the struggle, as Hitler himself has put it, the fight is one of the cross against the sword. We will take him literally. He has put us on the side of the cross, and so we are. And when he reaches his sword out to us with a naked blade, may a day come when we'll be strong enough to take that naked blade in our hand and pull it from him, and then lift the sword high into the sky with the hilt up toward heaven's blue, in order that the hilt may frame against the august blue of heaven's sky the glorious symbol of the cross of Christ.